Good morning, everyone. I know it's a very cold morning, but I think this is one of the very few times when somebody says a very warm welcome, they actually mean exactly what they're saying. My name is Tarianne Chabet. I'll be your MC this morning. And once again, I'd like to welcome you to the Africa Tech Challenge Season 2. I have the absolute honor of being at the launch of the Africa Tech Challenge last year. And it's incredible just to see what that journey has done to young people who are in the room today, and we'll hear more about that story in just a moment. So welcome to Season 2. I know that it is without a doubt about dreaming and inventing our future, as we'll hear more from Lynette and the team in just a moment. It's about Vision 2030, when you get to understand exactly what the ATC challenge is about. It's about youth empowerment. It's about Made in Kenya. It is about entrepreneurship. And keeping with the spirit of the Global Entrepreneurship Summit last week, keeping in the spirit with of the President Barack Obama and President Uhuru Kenyatta, this is about investing in our youth. As Frank Lloyd Wright, that's a famous American architect, once said, youth is a quality and not just a matter of circumstance. I'd like to invite, to welcome our guests today, and I'd just like to mention them by name. ATC Project Manager Lynette Ndile, a very inspiring and passionate young woman who'll be taking us through what the ATC is all about. And before I go on, I forgot to say hello in Chinese. Cao Shang Hao. You can clap for me. I don't think I've done it all. All right, and then we've got the representative of AVIC International East Africa, that's Shi Yanshuan. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Let's give him a warm hand of applause. And from Gearbox, we've got Maggie Xiaomi. From the Chinese Embassy, we've got the Chancellor in charge of the economic and commercial, Guo Su. And then from the Ministry of Education, Science and Technology, the Director of TIVET, Ministry of Education, Mr. Bashir Mursal. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. And of course, our Chief Guest Permanent Secretary, Mr. Joseph Tiampati, from also the Ministry of Education, Science and Technology. Thank you all so much for joining us this morning. Information. Okay, representing, of course, the Cabinet Secretary, Dr. Fred Matiang'i. All right, we'll go straight into it, and I'd like to invite the project manager, Lynette Ndile, to give us a brief presentation on what AVIC is all about. Lynette.
Zao Shang Hao. Good morning. So it's a beautiful morning to have everybody here to be able to support Africa Tech Challenge, as we have the launch ceremony today for Season 2. I would like to say thank you to our distinguished guests, Honorable Principal Secretary Joseph Tiampati, Honorable Commercial and Economic Counselor from the People's Republic of China, our Honorable Chief Representative of East Africa, AVIC International, Mr. Xiaoshuan, TIVET Director, Mr. Bashir Mursal, representing Cabinet Secretary, Ministry of Education, Science and Technology, and Gearbox Representative Maggie Xiaomin. All protocols observed, I would like to welcome each one of you to the opening ceremony of Africa Tech Challenge Season 2. As we all know, we are trying to create opportunities for the youth, not only in Kenya, but the rest of Africa, as we recognize that Africa is the world's youngest continent. Africa Tech Challenge is a youth empowerment project that has been sponsored by AVIC International in conjunction with the Ministry of Education, Science and Technology. It's a project that is aimed at upgrading the technical and innovative skills of the young Kenyans all around the country. As we all know, the Ministry of Education has established a TVET project, meaning technical, vocational, and entrepreneurship training projects. And with the ministry's support, we are able to create Africa Tech Challenge as an incentive to those TVET students all around Kenya. And last year, we launched the first Africa Tech Challenge in the form of a technical challenge. As you can see from the picture, we are saying that the future of the nation is in the employment of the youth. We believe through Africa Tech Challenge, we're able to achieve this. As we know, there's a very high unemployment rate among the youth in Kenya and the rest of Africa. Through Africa Tech Challenge, we are upgrading their skill so that they can be able to reduce this barrier of they lack skill when they look for opportunities in employment and internships. AVIC Vision is going beyond commerce for a better world. It's a company that is not focusing on only the government project, but we are trying to go beyond commerce by empowering the youth. Africa Tech Challenge was launched last year as the first station in Kenya. We believe it is going to go to the rest of Africa in due time, and we hope that season 3 will be able to incorporate the rest of East Africa. So last year, we launched it at the Technical University of Kenya. As you can see, these are our Africa Tech Challenge participants who are very excited to be part of this competition. We had our dignitaries who were able to officially launch Africa Tech Challenge last year at Kempinski Hotel. As you can see, we have the Honorable Cabinet Secretary, Professor Jacob Kaimeni, and our Chinese Ambassador to Kenya, Mr. Liu Xianfa, as well as the Commercial and Economic Consular, Mr. Han Chunlin, as well as the Deputy President representatives, Mr. Korir and Mr. Koej. So we are very happy that we have so many government leaders who have supported this youth empowerment project, because as you know, the youth really deserve the leaders' support. It has been emphasized by all the young leaders that we have and all who are really trying to create that youth empowerment in Kenya, that Africa Tech Challenge is just the beginning of what the youth will be able to achieve. We know that the youth are suffering in skill, and we have taken it upon ourselves not only to have a competition, but a competition that focuses on training. And our leaders here were emphasizing on the need of training to be part and parcel of the project in Kenya today. As you can see, the local and international media have really supported Africa Tech Challenge, and in the launch ceremony, they made that very clear by attending Africa Tech Challenge. For those who are wondering, what is Africa Tech Challenge? We have a technical challenge and an entrepreneurship challenge. Last year, we launched the technical challenge, and as you can see, we have these students who are all pursuing technical courses in different technical institutions in Kenya. They were present, and they selected 18 teams from all over Kenya to come to the Technical University of Kenya, where they underwent preliminary training, a preliminary competition, final training, and a final competition, which emerged top 6 teams. And we have our Chinese experts who are here for the 3 months to vigorously train them and equip them with the best technical skills that they can use in their future. Africa Tech Challenge is keen on focusing on the training that is provided by our experts. Last year, as you are aware, the Premier visited the NYS, and he had made a statement saying that the employment of the youth is the hope of this nation. Through Africa Tech Challenge, we are hoping to achieve this notion. And our Africa Tech Challenge goals include cultivating technical and innovative skills among our youth right now in Kenya. We're also trying to bridge the education sector and the local industries. Through the training that we equip them with, they are now able to be easily absorbed by the local industry when they are seeking for internships. We're also trying to improve the local employment rate, and we believe once they are equipped with skills in Africa Tech Challenge, they are easy to get jobs, and once they apply for their jobs, they are able to be absorbed. We are also trying to cultivate the spirit of entrepreneurship among the youth in Kenya. We are trying to show them that you do not always have to seek for employment. Through the skills that we equip you with, you are able to even start your own factory with due time, and you are able even to be absorbed by local industries, not only the white collar jobs. So ATC targets the youth who have passion in the technical and in the innovative sector in Kenya. You know, Kenya is trying to be digital, and we are seeing the fruits from the youth in creating this new digital space. Through ATC's 2 challenges, we are able to achieve that. Students who come to ATC from different parts of the country, they're able to integrate, they're able to socialize, and they're able even to exchange ideas on how to change this country. So as I said, we are focusing on a lot of training before the competition. So this is a competition that is focusing on equipping skills, upgrading the skill from basic to high professional skills of our youth in Kenya. The technical competition involves the basic lathe machines as depicted in this picture. We train the students on how to use the basic lathe machines that are currently being used in our factories right now in Kenya. And after Africa Tech Challenge, our students are able to go to the industries and operate those machines without any more training. This year's technical competition has been divided into two. We have the regional competition that has already begun the training. We will be doing 4 blocks to cover the entire country, from the northeastern to western Nyanza, Rift Valley, Mount Kenya block, and the coast Nairobi block. We will also be doing the final training, and we will be doing it at Shabarere University Technical Training Institute in Kakamega. This is to show that the Africa Tech Challenge also recognizes the evolution. Last year it was in Technical University of Kenya in Nairobi, and now we have moved it to the western part, hoping that it can be able to go to all other areas in due time. We will also be using the same lathe machines, and we will be training the same students on how to become very good high experts and how to make the accurate and precision machine using the lathe machine. We have introduced a new competition this year, which is called the Mobile App Challenge. We are not only focusing on the technical competition, but also in the entrepreneurship competition. This competition was online. We got the online applicants, and yesterday we began training at the Kenya Technical Trainers College, which is KTTC. We have 50 shortlisted people right now pursuing their training. Last year, our 4 best participants are currently having internships at the factories in Nakuru and Nairobi. We also got an ATC participant to get a job immediately after ATC. There was a commercial contract worth $100,000 that the Chinese companies, Sunny, were able to sign with our best 2 teams. And we are here also to thank Sunny for that opportunity to give that empowerment to the youth and an incentive. That $100,000 the students are currently producing right now in Kabete Technical Training Institution and Nyeri Technical Training Institution. They are currently doing manufacturing of spare parts worth $100,000 through ATC. We gave 3 scholarships last year to the top 3 Africa Tech Challenge participants. And today we are joined by Paul Warutere and Kelvin, who are here in front. These were the beneficiaries of Africa Tech Challenge last year, and we have given them a full master's degree scholarship to study in the most prestigious engineering schools in China. They will be pursuing their master's in mechanical engineering, and Paul is set to leave at the end of the month. So ATC recognizes all the efforts by giving certificates and cash prizes. We thank all the leaders that have been part of ATC and have been able to always show their appreciation to the youth who participate in Africa Tech Challenge. We have also incorporated ATC Talks, where we invite the successful businessmen, young entrepreneurs of Kenya, who are able to come and share their success stories with the Africa Tech participants so that they can be able to see that being an entrepreneur is not a dream. Their dreams are valid. And through this sharing of the stories, they are able also to achieve their vision.
I believe when I describe Lynette as a passionate young woman, you now understand what I'm talking about. I don't know what you were all doing around the time when you were 24, 25. Lynette has just turned 25. And every time I speak to her, I see that kind of passion. And I know that AVIC did quite a great choice by picking you to lead this project, because I see your passion as you do it. Thank you very much, Lynette.